Before the video starts, today's shoutout winner goes to Remix Sush. If you guys want a chance to win a shoutout in the next video, drop a like and a comment down below, subscribe with notifications on, and I will pick somebody randomly that will be shouted out in my next video. I hope you guys enjoy. Yo, what's going on, guys? Satsuki here, and holy guys, the Fortnite community has lost it once again. Now, I will start the video off by talking about the juicy stuff first, then I will work my way down to the not-so-juicy stuff, if you know what I mean. Now, if you guys remember in my last video, I briefly touched upon the subject that Ghost X, Ghost Shaw, Faceway, and Derek are making a brand new Fortnite team, and in this video I will tell you guys how this team started and everything you guys need to know about this team so far. We first started hearing about this new team when Derek tweeted out saying, "Me and Faceway are making a team." Then Ghost X tweeted out saying, "Making a team slash clan with Faceway and Derek." And when they tweeted this out, a lot of people are starting to get happy that there would be another team to grind for. And before I move on, I'm just gonna clear this confusion up for some of you guys. Somebody replied to Derek's tweet by saying, "Imagine leaving Face to make a team, lmao." Then Faceway replied with, "What lol, it's just a little team, is nothing serious." So yeah guys, Way didn't leave FaZe to make this team, and same goes for X and Shaw. They didn't leave Ghost Gaming to make this team. They are just doing this something for fun and something on the side to help all the underrated grinders out there. And the name of the team is Nova. And if you guys are wondering how this team already has over 70k followers, that's because this is actually the old Fear Chronic Twitter page. If you guys don't know, Ghost X wanted to end Chronic a few months ago because of some drama that happened, but I'm not gonna get into it. And Hantel, who is the owner of Evade, he's the one who gave the Twitter back to X. If you guys remember in my last video, Hantel posted an explanation on Twitter, and in that explanation, Hantel said, "Now to the current situation, X said he wanted the team page back. He wanted to start something with Faceway and Derek, like what Faze Mew did with Bunny Hop. I originally declined because I felt like something like this would happen again. However, I decided there's no point since they already have bigger platforms and could probably get a new page to 20k followers in a day, and there would just be more bad blood. Also, the page was originally his. The only reason he gave it to me was because he was getting hate." So yeah guys, if that rings a bell in your head, that it was the original Fear Chronic Twitter page. And a couple days ago, they actually ended up picking up their first few recruits to Nova. The official Nova Twitter tweeted out saying, "Welcome Ghost, Issa, Jacob, and Agaller to Nova." And like I explained in my last video, some of the Evade members were starting to get worried that Nova is gonna be bigger and better than Evade, and a few members actually ended up leaving Evade and joining Nova. The Nova Twitter tweeted out saying, "Welcome Whistles, Ralphie, Rinks to the team. Hashtag NovaRC details soon." Then a few more members left Evade to join Nova. They then tweeted out saying, "Welcome the newest members. These will be the final recruits until the RC. Clicks, Holbeck, Ju, Jace, Upshaw, Sean, Ghost, Enzo, Lewis, Iron, Yu, Cheetah, and Dizzle." So about 5 members left to bait to join Nova. And yes guys, Nova is hosting an RC soon. The RC will most likely be uploaded on Friday. And if you guys are wondering why Ghost X wanted to make this team, that is because he wants to help out the underrated players out there. He tweeted out saying, "So many talented players in this community that don't get a chance because orgs don't accept them or the clans they join aren't super big YouTube wise. No offense. My goal of the team is to give opportunities since we already got the platform. Like I said, everyone is welcome. RC soon." So yeah guys, this is a really good thing for all the underrated people out there. I would strongly recommend you guys grinding for this team, especially if you think you deserve more recognition. Derek tweeted out saying, "Nova is special and will never be an organization. We will turn Nova to what Chronic should have been from the jump, with no fakes or snakes. Amen. Y'all underrated boys stay tuned though for real. Our plan is to help the underrated that truly deserve it." That's basically all we know about Nova so far. So in a nutshell, what you need to know about this team is that the team name is Nova. The leaders of Nova are Ghost X, Ghost Shaw, Faceway, and Derek. The team logo has not been announced yet. The recruitment challenge for Nova is on Friday, May 24th, and their goal of the team is to help out the underrated. If you guys want to be kept up to date with Nova and everything that happens with this team, be sure to subscribe with notifications on. And also drop a comment down below and tell me what you think of the team name. Do you guys like the name Nova? Do you guys think it's too common? I actually want to know what you guys think of it. Our next story is absolutely insane, guys. This one's coming from FaZe Clan. Now, Tfue actually ended up leaving FaZe Clan, and he's gonna be suing them as well. In the article Hollywood Reporter posted, they said, "Esports bros sues gaming organization FaZe Clan over oppressive contract." And it goes on to say, "Turner Tenney, a 21-year-old professional gamer known as Tfue, says FaZe Clan is violating California law and the Talent Agency Act. One of the world's top professional esports players is suing his gaming organization for allegedly restraining his business opportunities and taking up to 80% of his earnings. In a complaint that argues esports players' representatives should be regulated like agents of film and TV stars. Tfue on Monday sued FaZe Clan for allegedly limiting his ability to pursue his profession in violation of California law, passing on a lucrative brand deal because of a conflict of interest, and failing to pay him a share of sponsorship earnings. In no uncertain terms, these gamers are artists, entertainers, and content creators. They perform, they act, they direct, they edit, and they stream. There's a lot of money up for grabs. Top esports player Tyler Blevins, known as Ninja, in December told CNN he brought in $10 million last year playing Fortnite. He boasts more than 20 million subscribers subscribers on YouTube and has racked up more than 450 million views on Twitch. His sponsors include Samsung, Uber Eats, and Red Bull. Tfue says he's missing out on these opportunities because FaceClan's unlawful activity in connection with a deal he signed in April of 2018. And he only gets to keep 20% of the revenue from any branded videos that are published on Twitch, YouTube, or social media, and half of his revenue from touring and appearances. His Twitch streams have been viewed more than 120 million times, and he has more than 10 million YouTube subscribers and 5.5 million Instagram followers. Tfue then says in the article, not only does FaceClan take advantage of these young artists, it jeopardizes their health, safety, and welfare. Tfue also said that FaceClan pressured him to live in one of its homes in the Hollywood Hills with other young YouTubers, where he was given alcohol before turning 21 and encouraged to illegally gamble. FaceClan also continuously pressured and encouraged Denny and others to undertake dangerous stunts while performing in videos. During one video, Tfue suffered an injury to his arm while skateboarding, which resulted in permanent disfigurement. Tfue's petition to the Labor Commissioner also claims FaceClan signed an 11-year-old gamer and pressured the minor and his family to lie about his age. He's asking for a determination that FaceClan has violated the TAA, that his gamer agreement is unenforceable, and that the company must repay him all revenue it has collected as a result of its work for him. And holy, after this, Twitter blew up. FaZe Banks, who was an owner of FaceClan, he tweeted out saying, "Yo, this whole thing with Tfue is pretty unbelievable. The first thing I'd like to say is that we do not and have never taken 80% of anyone's prize money. Not sure where that came from, but a contract like that has never existed. We've collected $0 from Turner's prize money. Zero." FaZe Banks also goes on to say, "And to have this all dropped on my head, without any warning, it blows my mind. I still don't fully believe Turner knows, understands what these claims are. I believe his team put this in front of him and encouraged him to follow through. I'm heartbroken, homies. I'm pretty bummed out, man. Like, F all the business stuff and the money stuff. This is gonna F with me personally for a really long time. I met Tfue when he was getting 100 viewers on Twitch. I attached myself and fully committed to helping him succeed, and it worked. Like, I got Code Tfue tattooed on my body." And yes, guys, Banks does in fact have Code Tfue tattooed on his body. He made a whole video on his channel getting the tattoo and all that, but regardless, the official FaceClan Twitter posted saying, "FaceClan's response to today's press article regarding Tfue. We are shocked and disappointed to see the news of Tfue's press article and lawsuit. Over the course of our partnership with him, which began in April of 2018, FaceClan has collected zero tournament winning, zero Twitch revenue, zero YouTube revenue, zero from any social platform. In fact, we have only collected a total of $60,000 from our partnership. While Tfue has earned millions as a member of FaceClan, while contracts are different with each player, all of them, including Tfue's, have a maximum of 20% to FaceClan in both tournament winnings as well as the content revenue with 80% to the player. In Turner's case, neither of those have been collected by FaceClan. We are proud of what we've accomplished together over the past year of Tfue and will continue to support him." They also said, "After hearing the community feedback, we'd like to address the issue regarding FaceClan's taking 80% of Tfue's brand deal earnings. There is a clause in Tfue's original contract where FaceClan could take 80% of a brand deal we introduced to him. For clarity, here's that clause. Brand deals featuring the gamer that exist on gamer or company's content creation platforms. If the deal is brought to gamer by a company, 20% to gamer and 80% to company. Let us be clear that we have never collected on that clause from Tfue or any other FaceClan member. These original agreements were created by our previous legal team, and every new agreement since last summer has maximum 20% to FaceClan and 80% to gamer. As for Tfue, starting as far back as September, we have been working directly with him and his attorney to dramatically improve his contract. We have offered numerous versions of an improved contract, some with a seven-figure dollar bonus, some with FaceClan taking 0% of Tfue's earnings, every one of which has been rejected or ignored, in every corner of sports and entertainment. Deals are made based on the perceived value of talent and the opportunity at the time signing. When talent starts to show dramatic improvements in value, it's a common practice to renegotiate based on that new value. This happens in sports, music, film, and TV, and certainly now in esports and gaming. FaceClan has made every effort to respond to Tfue's massive success fairly and accordingly. To be clear, in the last several months, we have encouraged and supported any FaZe member interested in hiring a third-party manager and or agent. We know that this incredible and explosive industry, including gaming orgs, would benefit from increased professionalism in every aspect of representation. We appreciate the outpouring support from our fans, FaZe members, and the rest of the industry. We always have and always will strive to treat FaceClan as a family." So holy, guys, FaceClan is saying that they took $0 from Tfue's earnings, and that they have only collected $60,000 from their partnership. Banks also tweeted out saying, "I recruited Tfue to FaceClan in April of 2018. These are graphs from both his YouTube and Twitch channels following the mark of our relationship. And in the graphs, it shows that right when Tfue joined FaZe, his YouTube and his Twitch blew up immediately." So, you know, Banks kind of made Tfue in a way. And Banks is really mad that Tfue just betrayed him like that. Banks also tweeted out saying, "I just had to tweet the actual numbers. Tfue makes millions and millions of dollars monthly, and we have earned $60,000 from our relationship with him in total. It's the most important part I need to be clear about." So that's crazy, guys. Tfue is making millions of dollars a month, guys. I can only imagine, you know. Tfue is swimming in money, guys, like literally. FaZe Banks also uploaded a video regarding this whole situation, and he got pretty emotional in this video. And FaZe Banks also debunked all the lies that Tfue was saying in that lawsuit and the article. And if you guys want, I will leave a link to Banks's video in the description down below. If you guys want to go watch it, you can. So Tfue snaked Banks and FaZe Clan, you know. But let me know what you think of this whole situation down below. And then Keemstar says, all joking aside, if FaZe Clan donates the 60k they made from Tfue, I'll do 3 weeks of Friday Fortnite. Banks quoted Keemstar's tweet and said, you have a deal. FaZe Clan will sponsor the event for 60k so we can officially be at zero total money earned from Tfue. I don't want his money. Never did. This isn't a joke. Run it. So yeah guys, Friday Fortnite is back. If you guys remember, Keemstar used to host this really big tournament and everybody liked it. This used to be the highlight of the week and FaZe Clan is gonna be funding it. Keemstar also said, quick reminder, hashtag Fortnite Friday is for the stars. It's for players that pull in views. If you are the best Fortnite player in the world but only pull 1k viewers on stream, I can't invite you. You should have joined FaZe. Keemstar also tweeted out saying, however, with all that being said, this Friday at UMG Events is running a tournament and the winners will get a spot in hashtag Fortnite Friday. So if you good but got no clout, there's your chance. So drop a comment down below and let me know who you want to see compete in Friday Fortnite. And as of right now, Tfue has not made an explanation regarding the situation, so we are still waiting to hear his side of the story. So make sure you are subscribed with notifications on if you want to be kept up to date with this story. Our next story is coming from the Obey Alliance. Now the four biggest content creators in Obey actually ended up leaving, and I am talking about Kiwis, Formula, Nyx, and Random. All four of them have over 1 million subscribers on YouTube. Kiwis tweeted out saying, I have left Obey Alliance. I wish absolutely nothing but the best for them, and I would like to thank Aeolus for being an amazing leader and an even better friend. Thank you for giving us everything when we had nothing. Explanation on my YouTube channel today. And in summary, all four of them left because they feel like Obey can't provide the things they need now, especially when some of them are closing in on 2 million subscribers. So they all left on good terms. They're actually gonna be moving houses and joining a new team. And we will find out what team they join at the beginning of June. The official Obey Alliance Twitter tweeted out saying, we'd like to wish the best of luck and success to Nyx, Formula, Kiwis, Random in their future endeavors. Thank you for everything. Hashtag you shall obey. So yeah guys, drop a comment down below and let me know what team you think Kiwis, Formula, Nyx, and Random are gonna join. But that's all the news for today guys. If you guys happen to enjoy the video, drop a like and a comment. And if you want to be kept updated with everything that happens, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. Okay, peace.